about to get into the next song. We Cry Together, Kendrick Lamar and Taylor Page.
Chat saying this is the one right here.
This song right here?
Yeah. They saying this song. Every song is a one. Yo, this song is a one, bro.
That song must be so wow. Like, I ain't gonna lie. I'm not a hater, my niggas. I'm never a hater. When niggas do shit that I've never seen, I've never clicked on a song and it said it crashed.
Get the fuck out of here. It actually said it crashed.
That song, you can't play Apple Music right now. It's crazy.
That's what they're saying. That's the one that they're saying that is crazy.
Yeah, and it crashed. That never happened.
My nigga, this album, bro. This fucking album?
This is it?
Yeah. They're saying this crazy. This song crazy.
I feel like I'm about to cry already, nigga. What the fuck?
Get ready, Pat.
Nah, this shit, this projection sounds ill as fuck.
Oh, this shit sounds spooky.
This sounds like Good Kid, Mad City.
Yeah. Shit remind me of Wu-Tang right here.
This sounds like Eminem's thing.
Yeah. Ooh. This sound like Eminem for sure.
This is fire.
This is fire. This is fire.
This sound like that skin on Good Kid, M.A.A.D. City.
Ooh.
Fuck you, bitch.
Oh my god, this song is amazing.
Nigga.
Nah, this is the black stand.
Yeah, it's like some crazy shit.
But a relationship, a toxic relationship.
A toxic relationship.
Nah, but I think it's dope for being, because Eminem was saying it from a white perspective. Yeah. And being a super fan, this is like, black, I mean, just relationships.
A relationship,
in
yeah.
I think having, instead of having Stan the fan, we're having a female that's in an abusive relationship, and I think that's even more crazy, because we see that more than the Stan version of a rapper and a fan going crazy.
You know exactly. I mean? Yeah.
This story is more relatable, more realistic. That's the word. Yeah, this story is way more realistic, and it be done like that in this way is crazy, because it's like Eminem did it, but this is a whole nother way of doing it.
Yeah, especially with the fact like the parallel of the female going with him, going back and forth, and her voice,
he's killing it.
It really sounded like she's crying in that room. Fuck you, nigga, you do, yo. Like that shit sounded real authentic.
Yeah, I think this can't be a play. This could be a musical.
Yeah, 100%.
That's what I'm saying.
This might be better than Carmen, nigga. A real hip hop musical, nigga.
Yo, honestly, he shouldn't do. I think he's gonna do a musical.
I think he needs to.
He's been with South Park niggas.
That's what I'm saying. He's so good at storytelling that he could make a movie. I think this is the one that he should make a musical out of, or make a movie out of, or something. But he's been doing this. That's why his storytelling ability is just unmatched, bro. You can't do what a lot of people can't do. What Kendrick does, they can't do what Kendrick does, bro.
Give me my keys. I'm gonna be late for work. Fuck your job. If they gonna be the day you walk to that bitch, and me, I got you out of for nothing. I do the same when we fuck. Act like this pussy ain't loose.
Oh my god.
You heard me, nigga, it's nothing.
Fuck you, nigga. Nah, it's
not creative, bro. Nah, it's creative, bro. As fuck.
This is one of the creative songs I ever heard.
Nah, right?
But I love when artists are able to pull off conversation songs. It's like Jonah Lucas, I'm not a racist, type shit.
I just think it's crazy because it's with another art person.
Yeah.
Like, she's really killing this song. Bro.
Facts.
Oh shit! Oh my.
I love how you did it, because Kendrick's able to turn up but not get in trouble for it.
Yeah,
the story's like, because he's actually wilding low key.
It's basically just like that revolving toxic relationship shit. Like, yo, no matter how much we argue, no matter how much I know you a piece of shit motherfucker, people stay in toxic shit.
Yeah.
Like, it ended on some like, all right, fuck it, let's just fuck. Like, all this shit, nigga, this whole song, but like, all right, fuck it, let's just fuck.
And I'm still critiquing each other's, like, gender. I feel like he took the opportunity.
That was
talk.
The whole world. Like, he did everything.
Everything.
If he knows, he tackled everything. Like, I feel like Kendrick feels like about a lot of shit. But it's like, yo, if I say that, I'm going to get you. But I'm saying it acting as a whole. I'm acting.
Yeah, this is another person like saying this shit.
It was literally like, yo, I'm tired of you fucking fem. Like, all this stuff. And I'm like, yo, does he really feel like that? That's a smart way of expressing it, but not being able to catch any backlash for it at the same time. And I think it took that Eminem Stan shit and it really made it more relatable. And I think this is a better version of Stan.
And even having a woman's perspective on that, too.
Yeah, forget it. I'm not going to go there yet.
He was able to say the other song is your best Kendrick song of all time. So
Stan, that's different. Even, I can't do that.
Even having a woman's perspective on that, too, to where it's back and forth, where it's like, I'm talking about the issues. She's talking about the issues she has with men. He's talking about the issues that have a woman. That's really the world. That's really how both sides. That's really
they
how
do that shit all
feel.
The time.
They do that shit all the time. So like, I think that's a perfect way having that other perspective. So it's not like, all right, listen, I'm just coming at one group of people. Like, this is how the world is. You know what I'm saying?
This nigga's so, amazing, bro.
This album is fire, bro.
That creative.
That nigga's a genius, bro.
The way they rapped on it really did remind me of that Stan part where he's like, I feel it now. I hope you can't sleep. You scream about it. Yeah. I hope your conscience eats it. You can't sleep without me. Like, yo, Kendrick, that was so dope. And I feel like that studio session must have been fire because I know he was like, yo, everything you feel about niggas, just
they
say
need
that.
They need a video for this.
Unavailable because it's too crazy.
It's too raw.
No, I think a lot of people have been going and listening to that shit.
It's a fire joint.
I think the next video should be this song.
Yeah, I can see it, bro. Yeah. What?
The girls are going to love that shit.
Hell yeah, bro. Nigga, she really was like, yo, he basically looked at her and said, if you have any pain in your heart, let it out. Yeah.
I can see like some of the lines in here being like a TikTok thing. You know how girls take use the voice or whatever and use their own attitude.
Yo,
that's
going to be you're right. There's going to be a lot of those for a lot of parts of the song.
He has two songs that could be TikToks. You could have a TikTok for Rich Barrett, and he's definitely gonna have a TikTok for this song too.
And then niggas gonna do the duet though, because then niggas could take the girl part for nigga part. You fake feminist. Fuck you, bitch. Not fuck you, nigga.
Tomorrow, nigga.
Yeah, hell yeah, man.
If you wanna watch this full reaction, guys, make sure you go to our Patreon, and we appreciate all the love and support.
Yeah.
If it's your first time here, I promise you, definitely won't be your last.
Nah.
So make sure you kill, murder, and smash that subscribe button. I go by the name Rob CDRT, and you could check out our Kendrick Lamar playlist, our hip-hop playlist, link in the description below. Again, I'm that hip-hop guy, that pop guy, that K-pop guy. Yeah, K-pop guy, nigga.
Yeah, that's that music guy.
There, I like that shit, yeah. And I know hip-hop, bitch.
Man, talking shit. You've been talking your shit lately, bro.
Yeah, Rob CDRT, man. Shout out to all my Haitian Sakwa, Sinabule, Pit. I sing on Pit.
Talking shit, boss. Yo, no bullshit. Yo, K-Dot, if you watching, my nigga, I fucking love you, my nigga. Great, great messages. Great moments and vulnerability that you had on this album. I can't wait for more. Right? I can't wait for more. Patrick R2.
Yo.
More.
You're greedy ass. Wait a little longer. What's good, yo? It's your boy DC, yo, Kendrick. Can't nobody do what you do, bro. If there's one thing I can tell you from this album, man, shout out to you, man. You can't nobody do what you do.
Yo, it's your boy Was the Anime King. Shout out to Kendrick breaking the cycle.
Oh, we forgot that song.
What song?
Yeah, nah, it was fire.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You said Chance?
The Stan song.
Oh, that shit was crazy.
Like, that's the moment he could make comparable. He dropped a video.
That video,
that could be even bigger.
I almost forgot about that song.
Nah, I did. That's why I'm like, I'm going back. I'm like, it was something on it. I'm like, yo, nah, this was the crazy shit he did.
Yeah.
That song, if he drops a perfect video to that, I think he has to play on that song. Like, that song got to be the one to connect.
Yeah. The R&B song was crazy too, yo.
The Blast song too.
The Blast song was crazy.
That's
gonna be on the radio.
The Rich, hold up, wait. What was it? The Rich Barrett song. That shit go crazy.
Yeah,
like
that play shit.
That's what I'm saying. Like with what we've heard from this album, like I think this album is phenomenal. Even off the first listen, that's why I could even say like off a second listen, I might think it's gonna be better than Damn. Like from top to bottom, like even the second half, there was a couple songs.
Yeah, I felt about Jack Harlow. Y'all niggas was like, this shit, and now a week later, y'all niggas was like,
My reaction to Melodic Blues is way crazier than Jack Harlow shit.
That's fine, but you still had a crazy reaction to Jack Harlow shit.
Yeah.
And the video was up, so I was like,
nah, for sure.
I can say, I wasn't here for that Melodic Blues reaction, but my second.
First listen's always, because Future's album got better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I still don't get me wrong. I still listen to Jack Harlow's. You know, I still listen to Jack Harlow's album.
His first album, which is trash.
You said what?
So he listened to his first album, which is trash.
Nigga, his first album got some shit. Nah,
his first album stinks. Trash, his first album stinks.
Like, that's why that second album is good, but
it's cool. I got some shit on.
But it's the man, the myth, the maniac, Wilkins underscore RT. I think this album is phenomenal. Phenomenal. Word. It's better than CLB.
And that settles it at
the round table.
Hello.
Yeah.
Shout out to everybody that was on the screen, man. Yeah.
Fact though, we about to. This shit about to be up, baby. K-Dot fan. All
right, I'll be right now.